Hey, good afternoon.
Smalley, how you doing?
I'm fine. Please leave my way.
Calm down. Why you dey fear?
I won't be your friend.
How can I help you?
You be weaker sister, Abby?
Yes.
I be weaker, your sister friend.
Please, leave me alone. Stop holding me!
Come back.
See ya. If you go house, tell your sister Rika, say you meet one of him good friend. Tell her say you meet Wahab. You hear me so?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Mm-hmm. Good girl. Calm down, not in rush. I know say just they come back from school. I won't give you biscuits.
I don't want anything.
Shh. I won't give you biscuits. I bring your hand.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Welcome. How are you?
I'm fine, but I'm famished. I'm very hungry.
I'm sorry. Hi. They say all these rich men picking. They see the chop. All the time they chop, chop, chop. Enter inside, go chop, right? I beg. I dare you if you like to finish.
Not when I was thinking there's no food in this house. I said it's chicken. Thank God. Oh, what would that pizza say? Not when I thought there's no food in this house. I saw this chicken. Thank God. Why didn't they cook food, Jeff? All the pot, everything is empty.
Amanda.
Hey, Mom.
There is no food in this house and you're here facing your fault, facing your fault. I wonder why you don't like cooking. You are a woman, Amanda. For crying out loud.
But Mom, I cooked yesterday. I cooked.
What? Oh, because you cooked yesterday, you are not going to cook again today. Is that what you're telling me? So we're going to eat sand, right?
Mom, I am not the only girl in this house. What about Rika? Can't she cook? Huh? In fact, I wasn't born into this family to be a permanent chef for everyone. Please.
Don't allow her to hear it, though. Do not allow her to hear it. You know what it means.
Mommy, please.
Since you are not ready to cook, I know what I'm going to do. It's just to get a maid so that I will relax my head.
No, Mom, you will not do that. Have you forgotten what the last maid you brought into this house did? She almost caused a heavy disaster, and we cannot afford to have another one. Please.
Then you have to cook. You go and cook. because your sister and your father might be home very soon.
Mom,
just imagine. I think she's here now.
Cooking.
That's very wrong of you. That's very wrong. I am telling you.
Mom is okay. I'll try. I'll try.
My baby girl. Big sister. You are welcome.
My darling.
You are welcome.
Thank you,
Mommy. My daughter. You look so exhausted.
Mom, I am exhausted. Very tired and very, very hungry. I hope there is food in this house.
No, there is no food yet, but your sister is about preparing something for us to eat.
Okay. How is Mimi?
She's fine. She's in my room sleeping.
Okay. I'll be inside.
Okay.
Hey. Mom, I can't believe this.
Me too.
Your sister really changed.
I am surprised, Mom. She equally acts after her daughter. Can you beat that?
God, I can't thank you enough for...
Thank God for my sister.
Please, go and prepare something so that there will be food at home.
Mom, you should always encourage her to cook as well. What is it?
Go and cook.
Let me go and get some.
Where is my chicken? Huh? Where is my chicken?
What chicken are you talking about? Chicken. What chicken?
Is there any chicken in this house?
Mom, I've not seen any chicken.
What are you saying? That the chicken I left in this house before I went out suddenly developed wings and flew out? Is that what you were saying? Annabelle, I know it is you. Where is my chicken?
I did not eat your chicken. Besides, I did not see any chicken in this house. Maybe your daughter Mimi ate it or something. I don't know.
This is your fault, Mom. This is your fault because you keep asking me to come back home. What am I doing for you?
Rika, you don't have to say that. You know it's wrong for you to stay in another man's house.
Well, then my stuff should better stop missing. You know what? I'm going out.
Excuse me. You just keep shouting and the next minute it's missing. Open the gate.
Rika!
How did you get in here? Amanda, what happened to you? Who did this to you?
I'm wounded. I'm bleeding.
Yes, I can see you're bleeding, but we have to go to the hospital. I need to take you to the hospital now.
It's late. I'm wounded. I'm bleeding.
Yes, Amanda, I know you're bleeding, but I have to take you to the hospital. Amanda! Amanda! Amanda, what stupid dream is this? Amanda, I hope you're all right. I hope nothing has happened to you. What type of dream is?
I don't know why your father would go and bring Eluka's son into this family. Eh?
Mom, are you still on this Eluka thing? This happened a long time ago. Besides, that boy is a good boy.
His father may be wicked, yes. But I don't believe in this children paying for the sins of their father.
My daughter, you don't understand. Eluka is a very wicked man. You see one thing? He who eats with the devil should have a very long spoon.
I agree with you, Mom. Completely.
You won't understand what I'm talking about. If you know how much that man hates your father, despite the fact that they are brothers, you won't be saying this.
Mom, I understand you completely. But what I'm saying is that what happened between Uncle Eluka and my father happened a long time ago. Even before Uncle Eluka got married. Mom, this is decades ago.
Hello, everyone. Finally, food is ready.
Please, go and dish out food for Mimi and Amanda. They must be very hungry by now.
Okay, Mom, I will do just that.
My best.
Okay. So, I need you guys to come in and have it.
Mom, like I was saying, yes, you have to let go. Forgive and forget. It's in the past.
Eluka is a devil. You see, that's your uncle Eluka. He is a devil.
You know what, Mom? Excuse me.
Amanda, are you having this wrapping? Why are you on the floor? Amanda,
get up. Amanda. Amanda.
Jesus Christ. Amanda!
JJ,
Chief Ewe. How's everything, sir?
Well, we're doing well.
Can we do? How is your brother's son and the new work he's learning? You know you have to put an eye on him this time around.
You're talking about Odinaka?
Yes, of course.
My wife is still insisting that I send him away.
Huh? Why? Sifeb, that is wrong. I know that your brother seriously misbehaving, but that is not enough reason for your wife to take that decision. It's wrong. It's wrong.
Well, that's my wife and her opinion. So it's left for me to say yes or I reject it.
Well, then, as for me, I won't give anybody that kind of right. That's the kind of right I gave to my first wife, and she almost rendered me bankrupt, if not you, that helped in that time. I would have died of depression because I couldn't have survived it.
I remember. Well, as for me, my wife has been very helpful. She has been a bundle of joy. What do we pray for? Make money, then get a wife, that will bear your children, to help straighten things up, give guidelines here and there. For me, I'll say I'm fulfilled. Because my boys in Europe, they are doing very well. Wow. My girls are done with school. And the last one we had, Amanda, we had it while trying to express the sweetness of our love. All I can say is that I give God the glory.
I wonder how you manage to live with a woman all your life. And you still live like just you met her yesterday. But as for me, I married four wives. And none of them could stay up to 5 years. One even left less than 1 month of marriage.
That's Janet.
You know that very well. No marital advice and counseling worked for me. I don't know why.
Well, it's the irony of life. You know, it could be good for some people in business and their marital life is zero and vice versa.
Exactly.
But as for me, I would say mine has been good. But that's why I actually don't shop for advice when I have problem with my wife. I just follow her the way we are and we resolve our problems and that's all. Hello? What? Are you serious?
Chief Ebe, what is it?
Okay. I will get back to him.
What is it?
He's my engineer. My project in the village.
What happened?
They said he has not been around for a long time.
Why?
And I spoke with him days ago. I hope he has not moved away with my money.
You need to act fast.
I have to.
You need to act fast.
It's all right. So.
Where are you going?
There is fire on the mountain.
Hey! James, come. Fire, mountain, where? Did somebody die? What's the problem?
Eh? How you can't know? Eh?
James, I'm not a soothsayer. I'm just asking you, because of the way that you are panting and you are running, what is the problem? What happened?
Amanda is dead. Oh, Gungo.
Hey. James, come. See, if not because of her, you have BS more than me, I would have slapped you this morning. James, Amanda just left our shop while she was coming back from school. Which one is Amanda is dead again?
Well, I go and see if her.
James, come. Wait. You know, you like behaving like a stray dog. I don't even know where to start from now. James, are you serious?
Because James, Amanda came to our shop while returning back from school, so.
Amanda!
What happened? Can you calm down and talk to me? What happened?
As I'm speaking to you, Amanda is lying dead. She's dead! My sister is dead!
Amanda is dead, how?
I don't know. I go home, went upstairs to call her to come downstairs and have lunch, and then I met her lying dead in the pool of her own blood. I don't understand.
What?
I don't know! I don't even know what I'm doing here! My sister is dead!
What?
I don't know.
It's okay, it's alright.
Chief Ebube, you people have to take heart. I know nothing will be more painful than to lose a child. But you have to console yourselves to continue with your lives.
Sir, please accept my condolences. It's quite unfortunate that you have to go through this. But life has to go on. Besides, you have other beautiful children. please, pull yourself together and be strong, because you cannot question God. God knows why. Please, take it easy.
Tochi, thank you very much. Julius, my friend, I thank both of you for the kind words of condolences. With God, He will give us strength. I think we should be able to. He will give us strength. Thank you.
I suggest she get buried as soon as possible. That's the name you use in your name.
Yes, definitely. I wish to bury her this weekend. She's still a little girl. Where we come from, we do not make such burial an elaborate one. Just immediate family members.
That will be fine. You have to take her and console your wife and your children.
Okay. It's quite unfortunate. Life is short. To think that I was just with her yesterday, we're playing, we're together, we had so much fun. I'm so sorry, sir. Please, take heart.
It's a mystery. It's a mystery like me. I
had a strong belief.
Just your name.
Odinaka.
Daddy, there's a big problem. That's a very big problem in this household.
What problem?
Daddy, Amanda Nkulebube's last daughter, she just died. Daddy, nothing was wrong with her. She's not sick, nothing, nothing. She just died like that.
Poor girl. So, that man has finally used that little girl for ritual.
Used her? Who used who?
Didn't I tell you that man you are living with is a ritualist? I know you don't always believe me because you like to listen to what your mother tells you. Now listen, the only time the villagers will know I'm a madman is if anything happens to you.
Did you get? Just...
Please, this is not the reason why I called you. Nana, you started now with your own problems.
What are you doing here?
Nothing, man. I only came to call my father to tell him what happened.
You are very stupid.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Wait. Was that why you are here? So what you do is to pass information of what happens in my house to your people of where? Eh? No, you will soon state your mission in this house, you. I will soon know your mission in this house. You will soon use your mouth to confess it.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I only felt it's wise for me to tell my father that we lost Amanda.
If your activities are not shady, why would you have to come and hide here to inform your wicked father of what happened?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I do not have any ulterior motive. Please forgive me, ma'am. I will not do that.
Wait, so let me even ask you one question. You, this wicked boy, is it your duty to inform them what happened? What if we don't want anybody to hear about it yet?
I'm sorry, ma'am. I will not do it.
If I phone, come on again.
You. I'm sorry, ma. I will not do it again, ma. I had no bad intentions.
You see, any of your evil mission in this house, yeah, it will surely fail. It will surely fail. Your evil missions will fail.
I'm sorry, ma.
You have failed. Adnaka, you have failed. Did you hear me? What did I say?
I failed.
You have failed!
Yes,
say it again!
I have failed.
You have failed. And you will continue to fail. You and your wicked father. Mark it.
Now see the problem my father happened to. I would have called you to even tell you what happened in this house. Now see now. Yeah? But what even happened to Amanda? She was not sick. When I come back from school, she came to the shop. And she left from the shop.
I overheard you talking to Odinaka. Why would you hit your brother so much?
Eh? He's not my brother. How can I call a blood-sucking demon my brother? No! I can never regard him as my own brother.
Nice, stop making this claim, Biko. Stop it! Eh? You don't even have any strong evidence over what you accuse your own brother of.
What strong evidence do you need? As soon as he became rich, my both parents died. You should have seen how he frustrated me with his wealth. At a point, I almost took my own life, if not God has saved me. For that reason, I will sever anything that binds us together as brothers. I will never love him.
But you are still living in his house. You are living in the house of a man you hate so much. Remember, he's going to bury his daughter here.
What house are you talking about? The house he renovated belongs to my own father. This house was built by my father in his own land. Therefore, it's my father's house in my father's land.
Yeah. Nine, I will suggest you make peace with your brother. So if one knew well, okay, Bakunu, do not rozo. Omorozo, they know. Make peace with your brother. Open and we hold you on him. Tell him, talk to him one on one as your blood. Corrupted, so he will understand that you have this bitterness in you over him. That there's something he's doing that you are not happy with. Rather than hating him so much. See, I will suggest you make peace with your brother. Talk to him. Ask him. In fact, ask God to change him.
Everything you just said, I have taken those measures. They didn't work. For that reason, I am severing any call that binds us as brother. Can't you understand what I'm telling you?
You on your own, Unai. Yes, so I and my children will not do that because he has not done anything wrong to us. Okay, the other day, he gave us some money to pay her school fees and buy all the books she needed. Okay, look at Odinaka. Because Odinaka is not good with his school, he now took him with him to learn a line of trade. Then after that, he will give him capital to establish himself. And you are still bitter over all these things. Okay, look at me. See all the things he has been buying for me. See all what he has been doing for me. And you want me. Banon, man, Mekwia, he has been good to me. Okay. Since I didn't talk about, he has been good to me.
It's all right. He has been good to you.
Yes,
he has been good to you. He has been good to your children. He has been buying this. He has been buying that. Now, woman, listen. I will not prevent you not to associate with him. But let me warn you. If anything eventually happens to my children, you will see the other side of me. Promise.
I will not do that.
So when you want to read a book, you go through the preface. The preface tells you almost the content of the book. So table of contents, dedication and prologue. Author, preface, chapter 1. Internet fundamentals, history of internet, services of the internet, connecting to the internet, world web, wide web, web browser, web page, hypertext, web address, searching on the web. Blog, Facebook, and MySpace. You have Facebook, huh? Chapter 2, website design package, Microsoft, front page, Micromedia, Dreamweaver, hypertext, markup language, elements in HTML documents, attributes, syntax, HTML structure. 5, JavaScript, writing JavaScript, running JavaScript, browser support, JavaScript, not Java, advantages of JavaScript, disadvantages of JavaScript, rise and fall of dynamic HTML, JavaScript libraries, add JavaScript to your page, add event handles. Tip. So you read this one.
Right. Plan your website.
Mm-hmm.
Why do you want a website?
Mm-hmm.
Who are your users?
Right.
Where will you set your content?
Right.
Where will visual design look like?
Mm-hmm.
Organize your files.
Right.
Who is the development team? Management rules, visual design rules.
Good. Chapter 9.
Adobe Photoshop,
right.
Adobe Fireworks,
mm-hmm.
other options,
mm-hmm.
screen design consideration. Hey!
Hi!
Uncle!
Amanda, how are you?
I'm fine.
You okay?
Yes, I'm good.
I got you this.
Wow!
And is your sister home?
Yes, she's home. But when she saw you, she hid herself and told me not to tell you.
Oh.
But because of this, I'll show you to where she hid herself.
That's good. I'm sure you like it.
Yes, I do. You know, apart from my parents and my siblings,
right.
No one has ever given me a gift.
Oh, that means I'm the first.
Yes, and you're a nice person. And I pray you get married to my sister.
Oh. Thanks for the compliments, and I say amen to that, but let the will of God be done.
Of course, it's will.
Right. So can I see her now?
Yes. Shh. Let's go.
I should come with you?
Yes.
Such a lively girl. I wish you never left. You know I cared about you so much. I wish I could bring you back. I would fight with my last blood. I love you so much.
Like this.
Sometimes I wonder what drives you to some of the decisions you take. Amanda was not sick. A very strong girl. Hale and hearty. Came back from school. Went to her room and lay. And gave up the ghost. And it never bothered you to ask yourself this question. What happened to your daughter? What happened to Amanda? Who killed her? Who masterminded her death? Whether it's a natural death or somebody has a hand in it, you never cared. Oh God.
Has it occurred to you that no matter the researches and discovery, none of these will bring back my daughter?
What if the killer is close to this? What if he is masterminding another person's death? Who knows his next victim?
My husband, why are you so careless with life?
I have seen a lot in my life on earth. What if the kind of investigation keeps her unburied for months or even years? And to even think that all this will not bring back our daughter, it has made me to consider that the investigation, the researches, or whatever you call it, are just wasteful ventures. Wasteful ventures, of course. Come, if I die today, please bury me and let me go and rest. And if the death is not natural, then let the one who killed me and my God to settle their problems.
Can you list it to yourself? Can you list it to yourself? Sometimes you sound so annoying. Why are you so annoying? But even if you don't care to find out what happened to Amanda, I promise you this. I must surely get to the root of this. I must surely find out who masterminded the death of my beloved daughter.
Woman, do whatever you want to do. But please, I beg you with God, allow me to bury my daughter this weekend. I can't afford to let her remain in the morgue. Please.
Amanda, is that you? She was looking scary.
What? My daughter, it's okay. There is no Amanda, okay? Yeah? I think she's hallucinating. From now onwards, we will not allow her to stay alone.
From dust, every man was made, and to dust shall we all return. Our body must be planted like a seed in the soil. Today is our sister's turn. We all believe she is resting in the bosom of the Lord. Let us all amend our ways, so that on that day, we will all meet at the right side of the Lord, to Patnama, and to marry forever with the angels. Amen. It is now time for the family members to say their farewell message before she's laid to rest. Please.
Hi! Amanda!
Amanda, my daughter!
Oh! Don't be weak in the spirit.
Kill your killers! Hunt them! Okay. Don't give them peace!
Oh!
Whoever the answer is your death,
make sure you hunt them.
Kill them!
Don't allow them to have peace!
Help! I didn't have where you
so, thank you. Oh, yes.
How long are we going to continue this?
No, 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 just tell me.
Doesn't it bother you as brothers from the same womb?
Stop me, Simon! I stopped being your brother when I started suspecting your source of income.
But I remember we had some good times in those days. Nothing happened to you.
Who told you nothing happens to me? Lebube, don't force words out of my mouth. You've torn our parents' house to better ground. Eh? I only allowed it because I am not the first son. I pray soon God will give me money. I will leave this house for you.
Lebube, how many people died?
How many people died?
I want to know how many people we have buried in this house.
Our only sister died and was buried here.
That was when I had nothing. When I could barely feed. And you are saying this?
Not up to 1 year, you made your magic money. 3 months after, our both parents died.
Hey, Luca. Why are you blaming me for the deaths of our parents? It's only God that has the power to make us stay or come over to Him.
Everybody, listen and listen good. I no longer see you as my own brother. And I want you to take it that way. You are no longer my brother. You are wicked, you are cruel, you are evil.
I overheard what you said to your brother.
He was even trying to make peace. Manejo, you kept condemning him. Ojo onjo.
I don't get it. Does it mean I am not a child? And who are you to tell me what is right or wrong?
Your wife.
You are my wife and you are supposed to stand by my side and not to condemn me.
I will only stand by you when you are right. Yes.
I told you that man is a ritualist. And he said he's not. You believed him. So you now made me a liar. Not so.
But the basis on which you condemn your brother is not strong enough for me to stand by you. That man is kind-hearted. It's even mother Kobo. Everybody loves him. And he loves everybody. Alone mother Aka. So why will you condemn
him? Please shut up. Who told you that man is kind-hearted? Because he gives you money. That made him kind-hearted. I know women lost money. Yes, that is why you are telling me he's kind-hearted. In the world of women, money means everything. Now listen, if anything happens to my children as a result of your insatiable crave for money, you will see the other side of me you never knew existed.
Dimoma, see, calm down.
Don't touch me.
You need to understand something, eh? Nanya.
I don't want to understand anything. Whatever it is you want to tell me, keep it to yourself. And don't you ever interrupt me. Do you hear me? Don't you ever interrupt me.
Now, cool down now. Come on, down. Eh? Wait to open. Nobody can keep. The man you called your brother, I heard the kind of rotten words that came out of his mouth before you. That man hates you.
He hates you to the bone.
No matter what, he's still my brother.
I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised if you're saying this. You have been hypnotized. Oligogi. Okwifurugi. Oligogi. A man that blames you for anybody that dies in this family. You still call him your brother. No matter what, he is my brother. I know deep down in his heart, he is planning on how to deal with you. He's planning to make you pay for everybody that died in this family. You are here calling him your brother. It's time you think. It's time you think and think fast. Remove yourself, detach yourself from anything that concerns him.
Mbeka, as you can see, I am mourning. That's why we're in the village.
You are mourning, and this is the right time for you to make right decision. Yes. Forget about him and anything that concerns him. Live your life. He hates you.
I don't know. Please. I've heard everything he said.
He's still your brother, so Funwa knew well. Biko, forgive him. You know, sometimes his words can be rotten.
Biko. Not sometimes, all the time.
Biko.
All the time.
Biko, he's still your brother. Don't turn your back on us. You have been helpful to I and my children. They're your children too. And I'm sure if they become something in life, you'll be proud of them. Kobozemoa. If you turn your back on us, Nkaye Bogopa. Biko, di mama, please. Oh, Biko.
Let's stand up. I don't have any problem with you. Neither do I have any problem with your children. Even your husband, I don't have any problem with him. It's just that ignorance is driving him against me. And I know that someday he will come to the realization that I'm the only brother that he has.
So for one normal only, the mama, thank you. Biko, don't turn your back on us. Huh? Thank you very much. He's still your brother. Darwin, thank you.
Mommy. I'm a family member, your uncle is. I hope you are living well with your uncle and his family.
Yes, Mom. My uncle has no problem. Just his wife. I think she does not like me.
Why would you say that?
Mommy, everyone speaks so good about my auntie, how she treats them. But at home, she treats me so bad. She sees everything I do right, wrong. I don't know what else to do to please her.
Then you check, you always get check, yeah? Check if there is something you are not doing right, then you adjust.
Mom, I've tried. I've done everything possible to make her to like me. But I don't think it's working out. She takes every slight opportunity to abuse me, to insult me, to embarrass me in the house. I don't know what else to do.
I suspect she hates us because of the way our daddy talks to them.
I wonder why our daddy wants us to stay away from the people that are willing to help us.
Esomchi, that's the same thing I'm saying. Father made us to hate them even before knowing them. Immediately I go to that house, everybody just love me. They treat me so nice, apart from the wife. So me, I don't know. I don't actually know what's the problem.
Odinaka,
mommy,
listen very well. All I need you to do is pay attention to whatever your uncle and your auntie is saying. Don't listen to your daddy. Okay, Nania. I just pray that one day he will come to realize that that man is his only brother and come to love him. But the only thing I'm telling you now is always be attentive. Rubeli Fizi, all the very important. Do you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Nana.
Yes, ma'am.
That's the only thing I have to say.
I will. Let me just see you.
Do yourself. Come and sit down. Leave me.
You don't need to.
You're still holding me. Leave me just.
Since Amanda passed away, I haven't been myself.
Come here, baby. I know, it's so sad. You know, her death hit all of us so bad. Yeah. I even heard they had a candlelight for her in her school. It's so sad. My poor sister.
It's okay. I'll be fine. Let's go to bed.
Go to bed?
Yes.